of the Chairman CPD Committee, Engineer J.A.G.R. Jarat, Vice President, Institution of Engineers Sri Lanka, also the Chairman Library and Liaison Committee, Engineer K.P.I.U. Dhanupala, Vice President, the Institution of Engineers Sri Lanka, also the Chairman Education Committee, Engineer K.S. Mangala Silva, Honorary Secretary, the Institution of Engineers Sri Lanka, Engineer M.G. Hemachandra, Honorary Treasurer, the Institution of Engineers Sri Lanka, Engineer Neil Abhesekara, Chief Executive Officer, Executive Secretary, Institution of Engineers Sri Lanka, Engineer M.A. Pandidharatna, the Deputy Executive Secretary, Institution of Engineers Sri Lanka. We also invite a representative from the Chartered Engineers to be inducted today, also a representative from the IESL Graduate Awardees, and we also invite a representative from the Junior Inventors of the Scholarship Winners, one of them. Thank you very much. Can I now invite our dignitaries to take this?
Sat 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 s Thank you very much. You may be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, the Institution of Engineers Sri Lanka was established in 1906, and in the year 1968, the IESL was incorporated by an Act of Parliament. Today, it stands with a history spanning a period of more than a century. It is one of the oldest professional bodies in the whole of South Asia and, as a present, has on its roll nearly 20,000 members from almost all disciplines of engineering. The IESL's vision is to be amongst the leading professional institutions in engineering and technology in the world. It strives to achieve this vision by becoming the apex national body of engineers in Sri Lanka, which ensures internationally recognized and locally relevant standards in professional practice and education in engineering, while actively supporting national development and diligently serving its members and the society at large. IESL pushes for development and harnessing the talents and professional values of practicing engineers to achieve engineering excellence and leadership in society through capability building, setting and maintaining standards, and proactively influencing the national policymakers to ensure the sustainable and efficient management of our country's scarce resources. The induction and graduation ceremony is the annual event of IESL to award the Charter for Engineers and Certificates for IESL graduates. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the 22nd induction and graduation ceremony of the Institution of Engineers Sri Lanka, and for me it's an honour, privilege and a pleasure to be the compere. At this session, the Chartered Engineers will be inducted, and 45 IESL graduates who have successfully completed the IESL Engineering course of Part 1, 2 and 3 will be presented with certificates. Presentation of cash and certificates with scholarships to 5 school children who are the winners at the Junior Inventor of the Year 2017 competition will also be recognized, and presentation of special memorial awards are also to be given away at this very special occasion. Well, I, as the compere, have welcomed all of you to formally deliver the welcome address. I have the pleasure of inviting a personality who is a senior professor in civil engineering and the former head of the Department of Civil Engineering of the Open University of Sri Lanka. He graduated from the University of Moritua with first-class honours in civil engineering, becoming the valedictorian of his batch in 1986. In 1989, he obtained Master of Engineering in Structural Engineering and Construction from the Asian Institute of Technology, again becoming the valedictorian of his batch. He obtained his doctorate in structural engineering in 1993 from the prestigious University of Tokyo with excellent gradings. Ladies and gentlemen, to formally deliver the welcome address, I have the pleasure of inviting engineer Professor T.M. Palawatta, President-elect, the Institution of Engineers Sri Lanka, also the chairman for Professional Standards and Management Committee. Let's put our hands together for a round of applause.
Hi, everyone. Good evening to you, ladies and gentlemen. Our chief guest today, Professor Kapila C.K. Perra, Vice-Chancellor, University of Moritua. Keynote speaker, Engineer Professor Clarence W. D. Silva. President IESL, Engineer Professor Mrs. Niranjani Ratnayake. Past presidents, council members of the Institution of Engineers Sri Lanka. Junior inventors, their parents and teachers, members of the print and electronic media, ladies and gentlemen. I welcome you all to this year's induction and graduation ceremony of the Institution of Engineers Sri Lanka, a regular and very important event in our calendar since 1997. Vice-Chancellor, Engineer Professor Kapila C.K. Perra, we are honored to have you with us today as our chief guest. Your illustrious military career and journey towards becoming the Vice-Chancellor of prestigious University of Moritua places you in a unique position to have an overall view of the engineering profession in our country for today and future, and to express your opinion. Engineer Professor Clarence De Silva, our keynote speaker, we are grateful to you for accepting our invitation and being present here today with us, coming all the way from Vancouver, Canada. Being the Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Department of Mechanical Engineering, University of British Columbia, and The wide international exposure you have will no doubt make your presentation a source of encouragement and inspiration to all of us. The chartered engineers to be inducted and the ISL graduates who will be receiving their certificates of graduation, to all of whom today will mark a milestone in their careers. On behalf of ISL, I extend a warm welcome. Dear chartered engineers, newly inducted today, you have been accepted into a hallowed fraternity where duty, responsibility, and service towards the nation and the profession takes precedence over personal achievements. And I fervently wish you the strength to uphold that tradition. On behalf of ISL, I also will warmly welcome the school children with their parents and teachers who have won prize places at the last year's Junior Invent of the Year competition who are present here today to receive their scholarships. We hope you will make optimum use of the assistance we have extended to you and one day choose to become engineers. On behalf of the President and members of the Council of the Institution of Engineers Sri Lanka, let me once again warmly welcome you at this 22nd induction and graduation ceremony of ours. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, to address you now on this very special occasion, I have the pleasure of inviting an emeritus professor of the Department of Civil Engineering, University of Moditwar, who graduated with a BSc Engineering degree with first class honours from the University of Ceylon, Peradeniya, in 1974. She also obtained a Master of Engineering from the University of Wales, Cardiff, United Kingdom, in 1978. She joined the Institution of Engineers Sri Lanka in 1987 and was elected a Fellow of the Institution.